Good morning, friends. I'm very happy to meet you all through this webinar. The topic of today's speech is Art of Publishing a Research Article. Dear friends, you are all aware that no one can be the expert in the field of publishing an article. I am willing to share my experience as a chief editor of Smart Journal and also professor. I have the advantage of gaining the experience as a publisher as well as teaching fraternity. Dear friends, the outcome of research are in three forms. There is a dissertation, thesis, and research papers. You are aware that dissertation means long essay, especially one written for a university degree or diploma. Thesis refers to a statement or theory that is put forward as a premises. The third form is a research paper, which refers to assembling of data collected, analysis thereon, and presenting them in the accepted form. Therefore, to my perception, there are seven types of research papers. That is argumentative papers, analytical papers, definition papers, compare and contrast papers, cause and effect papers, reports, and interpretive papers. So I don't want to take much of your time in explaining each and every method. So I have given you some details, so you, later on you can notice. So first is argumentative paper. Then second one is analytical paper. Third one is definition paper. Then fourth one is compare and contrast papers. Then the fifth one is cause and effect paper. So this is very important, my dear young researcher. We are all researchers in commerce, management, or economics. Almost all our topics must come under this category, that is cause and effect. Maybe we are all now facing the COVID-19. So what is the impact of COVID-19 on general economy of the country, of the world? Or what is the impact of COVID-19 on stock market? That will say, that way also you can take the topic. And more importantly, you can take the topic, the impact of COVID-19 on forex value. Still more, you can take a topic, impact of COVID-19 on investors' attitude. How do they behave? Or you can take the interest rate. Interest rate is frequently increased or decreased. What is the impact of interest rate in the economy like that? All our topic should be come under this fifth type of paper category, that is cause and effect. And the other one, last one, is a report. You know the three type of reports. Generally, while preparing the report, what you have to do as a researcher is that you must arrange the data in a logical way, and it must not use numerical figures in numbers and is result with those of other studies. So that is a research paper. The last one is an interpretive paper. Some details I have given you, later on you can refer. So with this, I am coming to a very core part of the speech, that is, why do we write research papers? What is the purpose for which the academicians or researchers are preparing the papers? There are ideal purpose. Ideally speaking, the research has to be conducted to share research findings and discoveries with the hope of improving the knowledge. You have to ask a question, is it really almost all researchers are conducting research like this or to meet out the ideal objective? If you ask me a question, no ideal research is being conducted nowadays. So what is the purpose? There are some practical purpose for which each and everyone is conducting the research. So number one, to get funding. So there are many funding agencies which provides fund to do research or research project. So for which we are doing research or we are preparing the paper, research paper and publishing. So that is a practical purpose. The second one is to get promotion. Yeah. Even if you take India, UGC recently introduced APA point and so many other points for which almost all academicians are started doing, research. And the third purpose, to get a job. Yeah. Even if you want to get a job, if you go for any interview, even at the assistant professor level or associate professor level, or even at professor level, you have to ensure that a minimum number of papers you have to publish. So that is the current trend today. For that also, each and every researcher is conducting the research. And the last one, to keep your job. Yes, true. Today, if you want to keep your job as an academician, you should necessarily publish some papers. Of course, in India, such a trend is not there. But if you go to Western country or some other countries, you should necessarily keep on publishing some papers in a quality journal. Otherwise, you will lose the job. So this you have to note, my dear friends. Therefore, I am of the view that the research are being conducted more for practical purpose, and very rarely the research are being conducted for ideal purpose. Then what makes a good research paper? This is more and more important. Dear friends, there are three elements, important elements to say that any manuscript is a good research. That is good content. So each and every paper must have good content. Then good writing. That is the second component. And third component, publication in good journal. Okay, now the question is, how do we learn all these things? Whether your paper has a good content, good writing, or publication. I suggest that you have to read more and more journal article. Before sending your paper to any particular journal, what you have to do, you have to refer the papers already published in that particular journal at least 1 or 2 years. Thereby, you will understand what is the expectations of the publisher. So that is more and more important. So when you are reading the journal article, you should approach with the questionable style. This is also very important. You should not read the article just for the sake of reading, and you have to put your questions. Why this particular analysis is made? Why this particular tool is made? Why this particular paragraph is given as a statement of the problem? Is it correct? So like that. So while reading any article, either in journal or in any other forms, you have to put it as a questionable form. Then only you will understand what is the good content of the research or what are the important component of the research. Another area which I would like to share with you is that the essential characteristics and qualities of good article. Dear friends, there are three qualities according to me. A good paper shall have, number one, clarity of ideas. There must be a clarity of ideas, which is very, very important. The second one, use of concepts. So in any paper, any researcher should use some concepts at least. And the third one, addressing the problem. What type of problem? Socially relevant problem. We are all commerce and management economics scholar, so we should focus on business problem. Then only the business community welcome and use our research findings. Therefore, addressing the issue means addressing the current business problem. And the another concept, that is a fourth concept, is a language. What I mean to say, the English. So a minimum standard English you should use. I don't say that you should use very rich English. At least simple language without mistake is very, very important. The fifth, quality is that presentation. So you should see that your ideas the text is very neatly presented, and there must be sequence and also continuity. From one paragraph to another paragraph, there must be a continuity. While reading your text or manuscripts, there should be a flow, there should be a sequence. So you have to see that. And the the sixth component is use of data in the paper. So when we talk about the research paper, you should use as much data as possible for research paper. So without data, you cannot create or you cannot write research paper. This also you have to note, my dear gentleman. Then the size of the report. Yes, this is more and more important. Each and every journal prescribes such a number of pages. Some journal expects 10 pages, some journal expects 20 pages, even some journals expect 40 pages. Okay, so accordingly, you have to, cut your length. Then only the publisher will accept your paper. This is also very important. And the last one, footnote and citation. This is much more important. So wherever required, you have to give footnote. And whenever you are borrowing idea, whenever you are using the ideas of others, you should give necessary citation in the necessary style. That is very, very important. Therefore, these are the 8 qualities which I see very important that all the researchers should note. The another point which I would like to discuss with you, that there are certain points to be considered before writing. So this is for the authors. So one side you are a researcher, other side you are an author of a paper, a research paper. So the first point is time to write the paper. So any topic you take, is it the right time that the publisher will accept? That is more important, you should see. So what is the current problem you have to note? Now today, Corona-19 is the current problem. So if you were ready to prepare paper on this, there will be welcoming trend from the publisher. The second point is you have to choose a journal. As I said earlier, each journal has its own objectives. That you have to note. And your paper may have the objective. You have to correlate this. What I mean to say, your paper must have the objective of your paper should link to the objective of the journal. So that way you have to choose the journal. Because the journal is available, you should not think that you should take it granted to submit your paper. Then tentative title and summary. Yes, this is very important. So you should give tentative title and start writing the paper. And after completion of the paper, you should again, we should be ready to make necessary changes in the title. So that is more important. And because you have given a title, you cannot complete the paper. So title is always subject to change. So you should be that much flexible, my dear friends. And the another important point, co-author. Yes. According to me, if you ask me, writing an article is a teamwork. It is not always necessary that only one author should write the paper. In social science, to my knowledge, up to 5 author is allowed. More author is also, some journal is allowing, but general norm, 5 author is allowed. So how do you add a co-author? How do you identify the co-author? It is not that anyone is your friend, he should not add. Everyone should contribute as a co-author. Say for example, one of your friend may be very strong in English. He may read well, or he may do good proofreading. Then in that case, you can include or add that gentleman as a co-author. Another gentleman may be very strong in statistics. In that case, what you can do, you can include that particular gentleman as a co-author so as to get help with reference to use of statistical tools or analyzing and interpreting. And the third gentleman may be very strong or have better knowledge in identifying the journal. He may know what are the journals, what is the current trend, so impact factor, this and that. So in that case, you can add that gentleman as a co-author. And some other person may be very strong in data collection.